Welcome to a new video, guys. Today we're going to check out my old Factorio bases. Here we already are in what I think is my first ever game of Factorio, actually. This is in version 0.12, so that's quite a long time ago. Quite old, obviously. I immediately noticed that you can't drag around on a map, you just have to use WASD. Yeah, nice map gen with like big lakes of water here, obviously. Yeah, let's see. So we have some science production in the middle. So the interesting thing about that actually is now... Yeah, right. Back then there were always like just four science packs, pretty much. I definitely have like... pretty big scaled alien science pack production right here. So let's actually look at a tech tree. At a tech tree, okay. So I didn't launch a rocket here. I was still a little bit off of that. I didn't even research gates. Okay. Well, this is on peaceful mode as far as I know, so... otherwise this would have been overrun by aliens already. Yeah, you also can't hover over, like, patches of ore and oil and stuff like that. That's also interesting. What actually were the cost of, like, the sciences? Okay, that's just a bit of copper and iron gear wheel, just like it actually is today. As far as I know, this is actually always the same. Science pack 2 is the same as well. And then for 3, like, one battery and, like, one advanced circuit, and that's actually pretty much like it is today. Dang, that's pretty cheap, actually. Except for like the alien artifacts, which you get by killing biter bases, basically. Oh yeah, so I still remember back then. I mean, first there's no main bus here. This is just a little bit of spaghetti. But instead of like calculating ratios or anything, I always build like these round conveyor belts, which basically just output in there, and then I can see like, hey. This needs a little more, and then just like turns around all the time, which obviously doesn't really make too much sense, but yeah, also this wasn't on both sides of the belt. I mean, it only comes in at one side, but I wanted to have it on both, apparently, so I built in a splitter right there. Okay, and then like for red signs, the same thing for greens again, with like this time. Actually also two belts, but like on both sides. It actually used both sides of the belt there. Some random steel production back here, and then nicely going around, leaving enough space obviously also for like the belts here. Oh, I have belts, but I can't press Q on there. Like that's definitely a pretty big turn off. Like the pet tool isn't there. Like also the resolution, like that's also crazy. Like now with since 0.16, everything's like so nice and high res. Jeez. Blue science production down here. Stack inserters. Okay. Yeah, also taking from the inserters for like the green science. That's also interesting. I want to see my oil build actually. Where is that? Let's just follow like the plastic here. Also a nice buffer chest in the middle right there. Okay, up here is like the oil stuff. Okay, cool. So the oil, yeah, I still do that. Comes in from back there, and then this just goes in here. Productivity modules even, like that's crazy. Oh yeah, the tooltips also look so ugly now compared to now. Oh yeah, I was just like converting all of that stuff into solid fuel, which is something that definitely makes a lot of sense. But that one with speed modules, so yeah, why not? And then some plastic production over here. And then going off down there for like... Oh dang. Yeah, like the sulfur production and tunneling underneath there, and this one takes in the stuff there. Oh yeah, but also nicely turning the belt around. Like I already had that trick figured out. Then they had a battery production. Cool. Also, obviously, a beginner mistake over here. Buffer chests. I mean, it's not really a buffer chest, it's just like for personal grabbing, but it's a little ridiculous. Same thing over here, like I have some steel production over there, but also some over here again. Just for like personal use apparently. And then coal, this one going also into a chest, probably also for like personal use. And then so it's like on the correct side or what? No. I'm not using two sides of the belt. Why did I like not build that straight? I don't know. I don't know. Yeah, some iron production over here. Like this is also an interesting layout for sure. Copper also coming from down here somewhere. Okay. Yeah, nicely. So it uses like both sides of the belt right there. And also again, I don't know. I probably try to like split that apart so they don't overlap or whatever, but yeah, well. Also, yeah, good old times with like the old steam engines and boilers where you could put like multiple in a row, but I don't really know like the ratios for that. Yeah, that's also interesting with the boilers here for sure. And I like a lot of them back to back. Yeah, I only use solid fuel for this one for some reason, so that's why like most of them aren't really running, but looking at a power graph, that doesn't seem to be a big issue there. Yeah, apparently this iron production right here is also not really enough, so some of them right there, and then there's obviously also the train up here. And some stone over there as well, cool. Now I'm interested in the train. This actually seems to work. Yeah, only like set that to seconds. Oh god. How does this work? Right, now I have like an entry. Now I think I can like assign this to that in theory or something. I don't know. Remove the station. Yeah. And now looking at. Oh, you could only do like time. Oh. Okay. That's gonna train ride then, I guess. Yeah. And one arrow, another arrow. Okay, cool. Can we go there? Hello. Oh, we have to run this train first. Okay, cool. Yeah, like this old train design is also interesting for sure. Okay, now we can check out the iron mine up here, I guess. All right, there we are. It is also now night, which is also not really ideal. Okay, so I also didn't really figure out that you could like put a locomotive on both sides, so I had like these weird turnaround loop-de-loop stations. I didn't even build the iron mine, I just like built a train here. Okay, that's also interesting. But I think we can go to the next map now. So let's see all there. So welcome guys to version 0.13. We are in the complete middle of nowhere right now, so dang. Let's just run back, I guess. Yeah, so just some details. We actually launched a satellite here, so that might as well be like my first game that I actually finished. I was probably farming like alien artifacts right now. This is a little on the loud side. Let's just. That should be a little bit better. I was probably farming like alien artifacts, yeah. I don't know, I'm kinda glad that this isn't a thing anymore, right? Like that was always kind of like a bad thing because like you can automate everything in Factorio, but you couldn't do that, which is a little weird. Oh yeah, laser turrets. Oh yeah, right, like that seems like so old now, but yeah, them shooting like the lasers as if it were like bullets. Also, like the graphics and all of that is just, I don't know, a little weird. Yeah, so this is actually the first of, oh, the last two maps. That's a little weird to say that, but it's map two. I think, I'm not 100% sure, but I think this is the second game of mine. I'm not, as I said, not really that sure, but I didn't find any other games as well. Yeah, and I actually made a Let's Play on this map on an old YouTube channel of mine in German, actually. So, yeah. If you do some digging, you might find it. I'm not going to say any more than that. And let's just walk back, I guess, real quick. Yeah, I just want to point out that I also did like a little of the turret creeping here. As you can see, like I like built turrets and everything up there. So yeah, also like just the laser turret icon design, that's just hilarious. I don't know, there's something about this design that's really weird. Oh no, I might die. Probably not though. It's like super close to my base, but hey. There we already are now. Let's just leave that all alone there. Oh yeah, the new train design in 013 apparently. Oh, I've got a package. Nice. I just had to re-download this right here, so now we're getting like all the achievements. Yeah, this is already a little bit bigger, so we have like another iron mine thing up here. It's like a lot of solar, some stuff in there, and then there's tons of spaghetti down there. This is still in before 015 with like the science changes and everything, so yeah, this is basically just like an iron outpost up here. Jeez, also with like a train running up here. Did I just like put a solid line there? Jeez, that's I don't even know if that works that way, but okay. Yeah, let's just walk down there. Yeah, I can still remember a little bit like how I thought that this is like a gigantic solar field right here. Yeah, well, times have definitely changed. Yeah, I also didn't have like my nice blueprint that I have now. I had to like build everything manually. There's also like a station there with some stuff. So yeah, I guess this was also like the first time here where I used the logistic network. And also where I did put down some concrete, and this is actually like the neat old concrete version, I guess. And yeah, that is like the super long train route down here. I mean, yeah, it's I think it's fine from the length. And then like a little bit of iron smelting over here. Now the big question, did I limit those chests? Because I do not think so. Nope, I didn't. Yeah, that's a lot of buffer right there, but hey. So there's like some iron stuff over here. There's still like iron ore coming through. Actually, everything mixing up over here. What did I do? Oh, jeez. Somehow got out. Yeah, there's like some copper mining back here. There's like some more iron mining up there. Some more copper mining up there, which is then transported by belt instead of train for some odd reason. And yeah, then even more solar down here, some more copper mining right there. I really utilized like every single like spot there. And the good old single electric furnace, which, if I recall correctly, probably did like some stone or something. Actually, yep, stone brick, correct. Those autosaves sure are a little on the fast side. Let's see. 2 minutes. Jeez. Never is also fine, probably. Yeah, some more smelting. Yeah, this is spaghetti, guys. I'm sorry. Where do I even start on this? Oh yeah, no, I didn't finish research completely, but I, yeah, back then, no infinite research, obviously. I can already see, like, another sin I committed here, like, that's the electronic circuit production, and up there is, like, a little bit of, like, copper wire cable. This is, pretty dumb. Also, like, productivity module 2s, and these aren't really getting enough copper, so... Ooh, mixed modules, that's like even worse, probably. Ah, but did they change like the science recipes here? Is that possible? I didn't need like filter inserters instead of like the stack inserters here now. But the rest is pretty much the same, okay. Oh, there's a chest on the ground. Interesting. Yeah, so here's like all the labs again, basically. I think I had, yeah. Again, a similar setup as in the first base up here with the red and greens, and then the blues basically over here. Also like super long, partially outfitted with modules as well. And yeah, this is like ugly module production. Like that goes in there, and I disable that, and it goes in there, and it goes then into there, and then that goes into the chest, and yeah, geez. Same thing here again for productivity modules. And manual fed concrete there a little bit, or... No, actually just empty. Did I... I think I that was also like stone at some point, and then I did like a mixed belt or something like that there. Jeez, I committed a lot of crimes back then. Yeah, some of that production. Yeah, it's like kind of weird, actually. Like you, with old bases like that, you kind of still loosely remember some of the stuff. Yeah, casual low density structure production, like miles away from the actual rocket launcher. Like that's all the defense capsules up here. Here, actually, with beacons and like speed module 3s, because why build more if you can just make it faster? And then there's the oil build, which is basically always the big problem, right? So there's like two oil refineries here now, but that is like going directly into that, and that is going directly into that as well. And that is an underground pipe for some odd reason. And then that over there, and then like lots of tanks over there, like directly connected chemical plants to tanks, like pump jack with speed modules, jeez. Oh boy. Yeah, and this like with the loop coming in, directly connected. Why even use pipes, right? Like you can just like use tanks as pipes. Oh boy. Oh yeah, also some steel production over here, like robots down there. Okay. I mean, at least I used like requested chests and everything. Like I definitely did some things there. And then there's like lots of power production down here, basically. Let's actually look at the power grid. Oh yeah, the old times when you like couldn't watch power poles that weren't out of your reach. Oh jeez. Oh yeah, because it's night right now. Yeah, sure, it isn't like really running that nicely, but actually like holding up pretty well. Yeah, also like definitely lots. Oh yeah, geez, that was hard up there. And also like a version change up there as well. Cool. Yeah, that is all looking pretty interesting. Yeah, I didn't have like too much space here actually. Like that is all pretty tightly together. I mean, I could have like shut that close and then that and that and then down there or something. Yeah, but I really remember like how I was like clearing out down here, because I just had to do it for like the alien artifacts. Oh dang. And yeah, that all getting triggered by all of that up there, and then I think you can even see the other side. I think at some point there were like aliens just like waiting there to get over here because the pathfinding wasn't like the smartest or something. But again, I'm not 100% sure about all of that. So let's go to the last map for this video, I think, because I think we covered everything pretty much. And we also have like this thing down here, the Roboport, with no modules actually. So that's also interesting. So yeah, let's go to the next map. And with that, we are now on the last map. So that's also season two of my boy. Let's play back then. Jeez, we got a couple of achievements right here. Yeah, I really remember how like that was definitely a big pain. I don't know like why this is like that, to be completely honest. I just know that is definitely bad, and that was definitely like a huge problem. You can see like the big walls of things around here, and like just fighting through here to get like more space. That was really mental for sure. Like that, I think that Let's Play also took like 120, 130 or so episodes or something. Yeah, you can also already see. By the way, we're now at 014, so that's like one version before the big science changes. So science packs should still pretty much be the same. Yeah, this, I think that with a steel plate was something else before. Oh, the alien effects do have a different design here than I remember. Interesting. That might actually also have been the first version with landfill, but I'm not quite sure. Let's also turn down the autosave interval from like 2 minutes to never, like just a little bit more, you know. Power, how does that look like, especially at night? But seems fine. Yeah, that's a couple laps down here. Did I like complete? Yeah, I did complete all the research in this one. Probably to get like that achievement. That's steel production over here. Okay, let's try and trace everything back a little. I also remember like that here is like the alien science pack production. Then there's like blue down here coming in hot from all the way over here. That's actually the first time I used a main bus. I see now. That's quite interesting. So that's all down here. Also, yeah, but not so much turn around stuff anymore. Like, sure, a little bit over here. And then for probably some personal use of stack inserters. Dang, taking it off like that. Yeah. Much has changed in my playstyle since then. Also, a bus that goes up. I don't know, I can't do it, I think. I have to build buses downwards now, but I don't know why. Yeah, but you can see still a lot of the stuff at the green signs over here with the turnaround. These basically right here and right here, and then there's like one dude taking off like things like that. The ratios here are also super messed up. Like it's 1 to 1 from gears to the red stuff. Like, I should have been able to figure that out quite easily. That isn't really the way to go, but hey. Yeah, that is also not super full here. Yeah, some like laser production over here, some like solar panels, some batteries, belt build right here, like all the different robot stuff. Then putting that into active provider chests. Why? Dang, I can't look at the logistic network like that anymore. But 389,000 green circuits. Why did I do that? Why was I this stupid? I don't know. Yeah, that's like all the defender capsule production up here. I also know what's wrong with me in regards to like the rocket launches thing. Like four of those, four of those, four of those. Like that is super far off, basically. Yeah, well, that covers pretty much like the main bus section up there. Down here, like all these chests. Why? coal. Jeez, 305,000 coal. Also these pipes going through there. Oh no. What the hell is this right here? Oh yeah, also nice that I used like portable solar panels in here as well, because like I had the space apparently. Okay, cool. Red and blue, and I don't know, green down here also with the why do I have like so many of those cables? I don't know. Some concrete down here. Yeah, there's even more green circuits. Yeah, I still kind of remember how I thought that this is like an insane production of green circuits. But the only thing that's insane is like how I built these. Actually, a blueprint book as well. Cool. That's like the blueprint of that. Furnaces One Direction. Okay. Chip Factory. Nice. Train station, stuff like that. Blah, blee, bloop. Okay, cool. Yeah, that's like all the copper smelting right here. That is also with a train. Right, like at the use all of this based on here with a lot of trains. This looks interesting on a... No, this is the concrete and not a train. Yeah, so like a train. Yeah, let's actually follow that path once a train is right here. Maybe we can... Oh yeah, it's actually on the way right here now. So there's lots of batteries down there. Over here's like lots of iron smelting as well. Also down here... Like there is probably some iron from there, some coming in from like the train or something. Yeah, like decentralized basically. Oh yeah, there we are. At least I figured out that these can also actually turn around. Yeah, that train is definitely taking a long time. Oh, now this is actually a little refined here. I actually also set the color of this for some reason. Empty cargo inventory, 60 seconds passed. Nice. But yeah, that's then like the first turn right here. Then going down through like massive amounts of solar panels. Also like batteries in there, but I pretty much just eyeballed all of that. So the ratios aren't really that clear. Yeah, also like all the base expanding levels pretty much. Can really see those with all the walls that I still kept in there. Yeah, it doesn't show like the batteries here for some reason. Maybe I can say like 10 minutes. 11,000 solar panels and 12,000 batteries. I think you have like you should have more solar panels than batteries if I recall correctly. Yeah, the iron one is pretty dumb probably over there, but yeah, I really remember how like the expanding, like how this expanding thing right here, like this wall going up here and then over there and then down here and then weirdly snake through there, like that was a massive project back then. Also like building down here because like you really had just to cut through all of this, and without artillery turrets you have like no way, right? And with them expanding all the time, yeah, you are pretty much fucked. Yeah. All these walls. Yeah, I really kept it all in, but that definitely kind of made sense, you know? Here's also the first time now using signals for me, probably. Like, I definitely did some things not quite ideally. Like, this up there's like one complete block, I think, till the base. And that goes there, so yeah. Yeah, like that's, I think that map right here is the reason why I now play all the time only with biter expansion turned off. I also remember like how this was a massive problem right here with like the two trains. That definitely took a long time for me to completely get that together correctly. Yes, then this goes through here and then back up. Yeah, because like two trains and both of these trains go to both train stations because there's like the other train station down They're like, yeah, this is coming down here now. Maybe I can get into the train while it's zipping by. Yep, I can. This is also not really that fast, right? Oh, it just feel like that 140 kilometers an hour, yeah. But it doesn't feel that fast. And yeah, that's like the other iron mine down here. Again, like multiple walled off sections apparently, and then like just tons of laser turrets out there. I didn't even bother to collect all of those alien artifacts. I don't even know how I managed to like fight through here, like what I did to like run through here. Like that seems impossible to me, but hey, I apparently made it, right? That's the important thing. Also, can I watch like the circuit network coverage? Nope, I can't. You can watch like pollution like that in old mode, but that's pretty much it. Okay, I also liked the nice looping thing around there. Yeah, it's beautiful for sure. It's a work of art. Does this train even get like remotely filled up? Yeah, no, this actually seems to be pretty full. Cool. Now we're going back to the base, and then we, I think, are pretty much done. Did I look at the oil production? I don't think so, actually. Where even is it? That's the other big question. We'll be probably able to find it. Those are a serious amount of laser turrets. Yeah, that's the problem right there. They're building like the base, like right there, right? That's like what should you do about that? Impossible to manage, pretty much. Yeah, also like no real splitters or like balancers, you know, like everything just kind of put together. Yeah, right here the nice oil build. That's all crude oil tanks right here. I definitely had a hoarding problem in this game right here for sure. So those are all the these guys, actually with advanced oil processing. So that's actually kind of okay, but like all, yeah, actually not all of them, but yeah, this is put together super weirdly. Also, just getting all of the oil products out, and then like, dang. Yeah, I think I started to do that like a little bit nicely, but then it just completely fell apart at some point. Also, things on like both sides of walls. Yeah, I did burn like that furnace down over here, and that also killed some stuff over there for sure. I'm pretty positive that that was not the best idea ever to burn down the forest directly next to your base, but I had to get the achievement for it probably, so that was a reason for that. Yeah, I think like right here was like the starting position or something. Also like nicely cut out everything right here. Cool. You're just taking coal away. Yeah, I think that concludes everything now pretty much. Yeah, now the power production, everything's actually pretty fine here as well. Request a chest and going like through. Yeah, here I did some buffering actually with the iron, which is not the smartest thing that you can do, but yeah. Yeah, no, I think we covered pretty much everything. So, yeah, like some like small outposty stuff around there, but that doesn't really matter. So thank you guys for watching. This was like a little bit of a special video today because I didn't have a lot of time to finish a complete tutorial video, but next week there should be another one. But definitely let me know what you think about videos like that. I will probably make like two similar more videos about Minecraft at some point when I like need more time to finish like a complete tutorial or a similar thing that just takes more time, and I can't get an upload for that week. So yeah, thank you guys for watching. See you all next Friday for the next complete tutorial video about bots, actually. So spoiler, I know, I'm sorry. Until then, have a great time. See you all then, guys. Bye bye.